Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to my video, and today we're going to be doing a review of the new RaceKraft 5051 V2. So this new 5051 V2 is pretty much an evolution of the original, actually I didn't get one with the same pitch, of the original 5051 that they released quite some time ago. And when this prop came out, it was a mega hype prop. No one had ever seen a design this aggressive, and they claimed really high speeds and good efficiency, more flight time, and a ton of people bought them. And they are a decent prop, but once this came out, it seemed like other designs caught up and really surpassed everything, and it became obsolete within a couple months or so. So now they made the 5051 V2 to pretty much try and revamp the design. Just real quick, let's take a look at the blade. It sort of looks like an HQ V1S and a Gemfan blade, pretty much all bound together in terms of the airfoil shape here. And then we do have the little wingtip. So hopefully I can get to show. We have the wingtip at the end, like many Gemfan props. And then sort of towards the middle, it has a very beefed up hub section, sort of like dial prop. So it's almost like a combination of a lot of different designs together. And just real quick, mentioning this hub design in the middle that they have this cut out. This was just the prototype version. The production ones will have just a regular sort of filled in hub like regular props will. So that won't be like that. So let's just get a quick weight on the prop. And once again, since the hub will be filled in, it will be a little bit heavier, but it's not going to affect it much. And it's 5.16 grams, so it is a little bit of a beefy prop, almost 5.2 grams there with the hub filled in. The props I fly now, the Gemfan Flash 5149, I believe those are about 4.9, so a little bit lighter. And then the original RaceKraft was 5.87, so this was definitely a very meaty prop. So it's just a real quick intro. Now let's put them on a quad and take them outside and see how they fly. All right, here we are outside for a quick line of sight flight of the RaceKraft 5051 version 2. Just real quick for the quad components, we have a Mode 2 Ghost frame. We have the Hyperlite 2007 1722 KV motors for 6S. We have some race lights there. We have an Akon AK32, 32-bit 4-in-1 ESC, the version 2. We have a Hyperlite F4 OSD, TBS HV Unit 5 race. We have a Foxier Lollipop. We have a Pulse 6S 1250, we have a Predator up front, and we just have a Nano Crossfire in the bottom there.
Welcome to OpenTX. Bridge warning.
So let's get this guy plugged in. Alright, here we go. So they feel decently responsive right off the bat here. Of course, this is a 6S rig, but this is a rig I've been flying for many months now, so I'm very used to it. Seems very smooth in these turns. At least it sounds pretty smooth. Still a full speed pass, but we have a HV battery. Pretty fast, but I'd definitely say there's faster props. I think the Gemfan 5149 is definitely faster. But that's a 5.1 inch prop, so it's not really fair. But decent overall top speed. It was pretty responsive in terms of throttle position changes. Spins up pretty well. Just in terms of the direction change, it feels pretty nice and light, almost like the old, almost like HQ V1S. It definitely is faster than the V1S, though. I'm still trying to determine if I like it any better. It's definitely a very well-rounded prop right away, but I can't find a category that it excels in more than other props. Maybe just smoothness. but then the V1S are pretty much as smooth and light of prop as you're gonna get. Yeah, it's very nice feeling prop overall so far. I guess FPV will be the big teller. Hold on, I gotta smack a bug off me. To see what kind of current we're drawing, because that'll definitely be very important. If it's an efficient prop, this might actually be a really nice prop for freestyle. I know they kind of want it for racing, but I think the Gemfan 5149 is just pretty much gonna take it as an iRacing prop. So if this is decently durable and pulls not too much current, might be an interesting freestyle break, because hopefully you realize on that stop right there, there's just not very much prop wash with these. And I haven't changed the tune at all. There was some prop wash. And obviously the tune could be better suited for these props than my old props, but I don't know, they just feel pretty nice and smooth. Yeah, they just feel nice overall. So now let's see how they perform in FPV. All right, here we have the RaceKraft 5051 version 2. Let's just take them up. Definitely do feel very locked in. Very tight and responsive, like I was saying, the line of sight. Pretty low prop wash, even coming straight back into it. Look at that. It's actually very good. Wow. And this quad isn't, this quad is beat up. There's a lot of vibration to this quad. Not very good soft mounting. And the tune is all right. The tune's not great. So I would definitely say there's less prop wash on these than the Gemfan 5149, which is what I tuned them for.
1 minute.
Pretty good power. It was a full power punch there. They are only a 5-inch prop, not a 5.1. So I do feel like they're definitely missing out there. In sort of this middle band, they just don't have as much go as a 5.1, so I really wish they would have made this 5.1, but what can you do? Let's do full speed back here. Pretty good speed. Like I said, I would say that's medium high. It's not crazy, but it's certainly not slow. Faster than the V1S.
20 seconds.
Let's see how many amps we're pulling. I forgot to look. 67, I think I saw a max to a 50 peak once the battery sags, so not too bad. I think that's about pretty even with what I pull on the Gem fans. Whoa, getting a little low. Battery's down at 3.6 volts. Not bad. Now the battery's getting pretty low. This is an old pulse, so it's sagging pretty hard. But I've been flying for almost 3 minutes now. And I pulled about 1,100 milliamps, so its battery's just about done. This is 1,250. Yeah, now it's really sagging 3.3, so I'm gonna bring it back in. So about 3 minutes, 1,150 milliamps. Not bad. I think that might be a little bit more efficient than the Gemfan, but I did have less power, since, of course, they're only a 5-inch prop. But they were pretty nice and smooth. All right, so here we are back inside to finish up on the RaceKraft 5051 version 2. So pretty much as I explained in the flight testing, these are pretty much just an all-around, really decent, well-rounded prop. The area that they impressed me most in was sort of the smooth, good prop wash handling category for more of a freestyle. However, be that as it may, I just don't really know what type of application these would be best for, because for freestyle, a lot of people are going to be looking at the V1S prop, very, very smooth, very durable, very lightweight, efficient prop that works well for freestyle. And then for racing, a lot of people are going to be looking at the GemFan 5149, very powerful prop, very aggressive, very responsive. These are pretty much freestyle racing, which is what I use, so I'm not really sure where these ones fall in. In terms of durability, I actually didn't crash these at all, so I'm not sure, but it is the sort of old style RaceKraft material. I'm not sure if it's going to be durable. I mean, just try bending it here. It's pretty stiff, especially up at the hub, but I'm worried if you do get a good hit, it's going to bend down. That's not too bad. It definitely did deform a little bit, but they seem pretty durable, a lot more durable than the original RaceKrafts. These have a lot more material around the hub here. In terms of price, they do come in at $6 for two sets, so it's $3 a set, so that's actually pretty much one of the cheapest props out there, so if you want to get a bunch of basher props, these might be a good idea, and they're going to be way, way better than props you're going to get off Banggood, like the Ishin Wizard props. Those are pretty much trash. The Wizard props are actually a clone of these original 5051s, so definitely don't get those. But yeah, really nice prop overall. It just didn't really wow me in any category. It's just very well-rounded. So I think they might suit a lot of people if you didn't like the characteristics of these two popular props. So there'll be a link down in the description below if you're interested. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video.